So myself and a group of friends are going to see the long-awaited film, the sequel to the 2009 film of much controversy amongst Trekkies, Star Trek Into Darkness. The sequel, directed by J.J. Abrams, once again, is going to be directing Star Wars 7, as we're all freaking out about. And so I've made my room all very decorative and organized and pretty. This is a short film on our theatrical experience of seeing the film and our thoughts afterwards. And yes, the theme from the last movie, the end credits, is playing on my stereo right now. So anyway, we'll see if the theater people kick me out because I have a camera. All right, there he is, Mr. James Ware. How are you?
I'm great.
Awesome. Is John coming then? Oh, there he is. Hey, John.
Hey.
Ready to see a Star Trek movie? Well, not a Star Trek movie, but a hopefully good imitation.
I'm glad that you wore your suit, Wes. I would have felt really awkward walking in with this without anyone else wearing suits.
Well, I'm glad we decided to wear suits. That was a great innovation.
Oh, yeah. Yep. And
I just wore this. Not much.
I filmed you like this when we did the Nerd Wars podcast episode.
I'd forgotten about that. Did you get permission to bring that in?
The thing is, I wasn't able to phone them in time, but I assume that they'll trust me because I'm wearing a suit.
We'll see. I like the red tie, too. That looks
just
really good
on you. Just tell them that you are a movie critic.
No kidding.
We're going to look like film critics walking in.
Yeah.
Since we are, after all, wearing suits, we want to be very formal about everything. So we are not going to the movie theater. We are going to the cinema. And we're not going to see a movie. We're going to see a motion picture or a film.
John S. Mom, though. She wanted him to try to sneak his camcorder into the theater and get a really cheeky bootleg copy of the film for her.
Well, it looked just like the normal film anyway, with all the shaky cam.
It's true.
I'll have to just sneak mine in there then.
No, don't do that.
There it is.
Plus, I mean, you can't run a camera and pay attention to the film at the same time.
This is true.
Yeah, not quite as impressive as this, right?
They're packed.
Oh man.
Everybody there is going to Star Trek.
I'm sure. Either Star Trek or Iron Man 3, they're the only two big movies out there.
Alright, here we are. We're entering the movie theater. The aroma of popcorn just hits you, doesn't it?
I feel like we're not the only people in here with suits.
Yeah, us in the cardboard box.
This is our precious, precious coupons. $5 off and $2 off.
Very good. So have you guys seen any Into Darkness posters in the theater?
No,
that's weird.
Yeah, at the other theater they had tons of posters for the film.
A big backsplash behind the behind the employees.
Alright, there are our friends. We're making the scene. We've got one more on the way after this.
One more on the way.
One more.
Morning, Sophie, EJ.
Hello,
Rice.
Folks.
Hello.
Here we are. All right, here's the skeptic, the Star Trek skeptic.
I'm in a hostile place right now.
You're in a hostile place?
Feeling the Ahsoka.
You'll identify with the Klingon in this film. Because they'll want to beat up all the good guys.
You may have to provide duct tape so I don't boo the whole time.
Yeah, don't boo, please.
Well, you showing up here is a miracle well on its own. How are you, Grace?
All right.
EJ?
Hi.
Excited to see a movie?
No.
Yeah, sure.
I can't believe I'm spending $4 of my own personal money.
$4 of her own money?
On Star Trek.
On a Star Trek movie.
Wow.
I think you're going to see this just because you've heard so much propaganda from the Trekkies that this isn't a real Star Trek film.
That helps.
Real Star Trek film.
In my mind,
this
I bet
fake.
It will be.
At its,
fake.
At its best, it will be extremely entertaining and action-packed and some good character
stuff. At worst, it'll be Star Trek 2009 all over again.
Well, yeah.
I'm already hating this. I haven't even been here 5 minutes.
Now, for people who don't know, Sophie hates Star Trek.
Kind of obvious. 5 minutes ago.
No.
That's true.
I love Ahsoka. Don't think I'm a Trekkie.
Yeah.
Because I'm not.
I would never accuse you of being a Trekkie, Sophie.
No.
Nobody in their right mind.
My brain functions higher than that.
Oof. Gee whizzo. Well, that's highly debatable.
It's a parallel reality, really.
If you ask me, I think you have delusions of grandeur. Whatever
grandeur.
That means.
Wes, that's grandeur.
Well, heck, I've only heard it spelled. And when
what?
When Han Solo said it, it sounded like Grand Church.
What?
So, I was at the Northwoods Mall, and I was wearing this shirt, this Batman shirt, complete with a cape attachment. And some creepy guy walks up to me and goes, "Hey, I like your shirt. Can I give you a hug?"
Okay.
And I screamed, "No!"
and promptly walk away.
Oh,
she
gosh.
And I were there. He was like this creepy kind of like marijuana smoking.
Wow.
Like old deadbeat guys.
The kind of go that go
He's
to
like,
a G.I. Joe
Can
movie.
I give you a hug? And I'm like, no, I don't know you.
Oh, gosh.
I was really scared.
Look at that. She's Batgirl or something.
No, I hate Batgirl.
She hates
I do
hate
too.
Batgirl. No, it's actually
and the
one.
Colon.
Look at this.
They forgot the colon.
Well, actually, the film doesn't have a colon by design. If you look on the posters, it doesn't have a colon. That was the big controversy of this film as well. That it's not Star Trek colon Into Darkness. It's Star Trek Into Darkness. I was so infuriated about that.
I would have put
oh
the colon.
Oh my goodness.
But look at this. Star Trek Darkness. What
Get
the heck?
Sue somebody. Oh my god.
Maybe they're putting the word dark into it to attract Batman
Wesley
fans.
Someone behind you.
I'm very sorry, ma'am.
No problem.
I forgot there was a door there.
You're embarrassingly sorry.
How are you doing?
Okay, Anna, $2 off coupon.
A DC shirt and a Marvel shirt. That's
Marvel for
good.
The win. I'm just not a DC guy.
I am already
I'm feeling the hate really, really bad today. Hate's so good.
Oh, look, it's Channing Tatum.
Oh, there's your guy.
I hate him. I hate
oh, I thought you had a crush on him.
I don't have a crush. I used to have a crush on Channing Tatum. No, I just kind of.
Oh, some disturbing violence.
No kidding. Well, you
are
and James are obviously
disturbed?
Sitting next to me.
No, Wes, the Hunger Games.
Oh, no, the sequel?
Oh, no. Oh, no, 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 no.
Good job.
Okay, so Marvel, Star Trek, and the Hunger Games in one day? I don't think I can take it. I'm going to snap.
Well, you can look at Grace's shirt for relief. James, look at the Star Trek bowling pins and the popcorn. That's phenomenal.
Look at it.
Are you looking forward to that?
Yes. Are you ready? I'm kind of wearing a DC shirt.
Okay, Grace, what were you and Sophie doing during the whole movie?
We were laughing.
Peg was like,
you were laughing at the movie?
Yeah.
But I could see
we laughed really hard in the scene where Kirk died. We thought that was hilarious.
It's terrible. All right, well, as you can tell, we're out of the movie now, and Sophie's trying to waste her money by buying a G.I. Joe Retaliation poster, I think. Okay, so Sophie, you just got to try to get a G.I. Joe Retaliation poster.
I did.
But the only ones that they have here, in the darkness there, is posters for the zookeeper. And we all want posters for the zookeeper to hang up in our rooms. And I also shredded
the shredded Oblivion.
I shredded Ruse Vian, the movie Ruse Vian. So you genuinely dislike the movie?
We'll get into this later.
we'll get into it soon.
Well, no. I hate the Star Trek universe. I hate it. It's awful. But there's some stuff I did like.
Okay.
Yeah. I didn't like anything.
What was that chick's name that I like again?
Uhuru.
Yes. All right, let's go.
All right, now we're back to my living spaces.
Where are they? I lost them.
I have no idea where they went to. All right.
Are they trying to lose us?
Trying to lose us, I bet. Sounds about right.
Cool, I could care less.
Hey, be nice.
Your cape's flowing in the wind, you
it
said?
Was.
Yeah, Wes said I sound creepy like Benedict.
Now, guys, look at James, look at him closely, and he looks exactly like Khan does in this film,
Benedict
Cumberbatch.
Like Benedict Cumberbatch at all.
He does!
I was gonna.
He does!
More in the Spock side than the Khan.
I disagree.
No, he does not look like Spock.
No, James, turn to us. Do your shall we
begin. Now, shall we begin?
We don't have even very good lighting. Okay,
no.
Now.
Freddy, I gotta channel my inner John Pertwee. Now, shall we begin?
I think he looks like Khan.
He thinks he does.
I think so.
Okay.
Just my opinion. All right.
I'm not buying any of this stuff.
Okay. Oh, Frisco.
Sophie disapproves of the original Uhura.
I do. She's ugly.
She's
I
ugly.
I like Zoe better.
Now, this is what's so funny about Sophie, is you were complaining about Zoe just the other day.
I know, at the picnic, I was totally dissing on her, but now I like her.
What were you saying about her then?
What did I say?
I said whenever she's in a sci-fi movie,
it ruins it, something like
yeah.
that. Which, I mean, I'm not saying this was a good sci-fi movie, am I?
What's this, James?
Hal.
Computer, James' computer.
My computer, Hal.
And there is the director's edition of Star Trek Motion Picture.
Which is gone from me.
Yes.
I want it back.
I thought I'd just display it there.
Sure.
Yes.
Did Spock and the chick that I think is cool get together in the 2009 movie?
Yes.
Yeah.
Ew, I bet that was awkward.
It was. The Trekkies, it was. It's like, what?
It
what's this?
Because
45
Spock
years.
Never, and... Spock was never in love with anybody.
Spock is an idiot. He really ruined that for me. Oh, Sophie really did.
Well. There's a triple from TOS.
Oh, that's right. There is a triple.
That's too awkward.
That wasn't, that was, I don't like how they go chop, 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 chop.
Who were the people in the beginning? What the heck were they doing to find out the red planet?
Did you find that?
That was Kirk, Spock, and McCoy, and they were trying to save the planet.
Okay.
Motion picture with no sound is very boring.
What are you guys laughing about?
How dumb Star Trek is.
Really? Anna,
what is... I was just laughing at you guys. Little talk.
All right, so let's go one by one here. Sophie, your thoughts have already been well documented, but could you elaborate a little bit?
Ask me. Okay, so say a character's name. I will say it. Yes. No. Sort of.
Kirk. Spock. Uhura.
What?
McCoy.
Who the heck was that?
Were
they bones?
Yes.
Oh,
bones.
Yes, Dr. Leonard McCoy.
Got him. No.
Okay, who did you like? I'm tired of getting thumbs down. Who did you like in the movie?
Uhura.
Okay.
That was it.
What about Khan?
He was kind of a... I thought he was totally random. Maybe it's because I'm not Trekkie, but...
Yeah.
What the heck? He just breaks people's skull. I mean, what the heck was that? And his blood can bring you back to... I was totally blind.
I can see for non-Trekkies, that would be confusing because they didn't show the flashback of the Botany Bay. Sorry.
Well, yeah, there was a lot in this movie that they borrowed from the previous timeline.
Yeah, because they have Star Trek, an episode of Star Trek called Space Sea from the original series, and a Star Trek movie called Star Trek II Wrath of Khan. That explains all the background of Khan, and which I don't expect you to watch, but they assume that you know the background, so I don't explain it. I liked it because I have a working knowledge base for people who don't.
Right.
They wouldn't understand it.
You know, interestingly enough, the newspaper in their review said the dead opposite. They said, if you've never experienced Star Trek before, this will make perfect sense to you.
And that's what my Uncle Dale said, and I totally disagree with that.
I didn't understand the background, but I could follow what was going on. I mean, I understood what was happening, but there's just some parts that I just...
Mm-hmm. You don't have an appreciation for a lot of elements in it.
Oh, probably not. Yeah. Every time someone laughs, I'd be like, why is that funny?
I find it ironic that we think that some of the things that were borrowed from the previous canon were underdeveloped. Considering that these movies are made for non-Trekkies. J.J. Abrams isn't a Trekkie, and that's why there's so much controversy amongst the fans.
Decent. Yeah. I bet the original Trek I'd be
low. Oh, you understand original Trek because you haven't grown up with it.
All right, so...
Oh, really?
I found it decent?
So let's get on to Anna here. She is not a Star Trek fan by any means. She's wearing a Marvel shirt there, so you know she's a Marvel fan. But so what did you think of your first Star Trek experience?
I thought it was very interesting, and okay. I found it very easy. Story like to follow along with.
Mm-hmm. EJ.
every time something that was supposed to be melodramatic and touching would happen, I'd look over and EJ be laughing.
If you watch
like
Star Trek, if you
thought bucket, she was like,
if you thought that was boring, if you tried watching this, you would probably be asleep.
No, that's the best movie ever made.
That
right
is
there.
The best movie on one of the best movies ever made.
John. Huge Star Trek fan here. She's highly anti-Trek.
In the middle.
Yeah, in the middle. And EJ just...
She's just anti-Trek.
She pukes it up. John, what did you think of this movie?
I liked the movie. I liked the storyline. There could have been a few things that could have been deleted, like some language.
I thought the language was presented in sort of a dumb fashion.
There were a couple
of
scenes that they could have done away with.
What do you expect in your average action movie?
Exactly.
I don't
watch
a lot of modern movies, so that's why I probably found some of it offensive.
It was so J.J. Abrams' 2013 imitation of Star Trek. You know, McCoy's about to say the SH word, and then the shh of the door. He's like, who would have thought of that?
That was amusing.
It's such a departure from the Star Trek that you know, that's always so regal and, you know.
Oh, majestic.
And, indeed.
Well,
I find that majestic.
Shh. Movie overall, I enjoyed it. It's not as good as any other Trek I've seen. I like the other Treks better.
Yeah.
A few things that bugged me, this is kind of nitpicking it, but all the actors should have been older for the cast. They were older in the original series. They should have been older.
Well, I'm over that. All those sort of thoughts that I had about the cast were 2009, and now I think the cast is great. I just hope for good movies from them.
Yeah. And Khan should have been older. Khan bugged me.
Yes,
age.
He should have.
He should have been older than Kirk. He was older
than
Kirk.
Well, he needed to be as old as the main characters.
And his... And accent was all wrong. He wasn't British in the original series.
Ricardo Montalban.
Yes.
You know what? I have a picture of the original Khan on my calendar.
Oh.
That's the original Sulu.
He's a hunk.
He is.
Oh my gosh.
What?
Oh, there's the SS. There's the Botany Bay. They should have put the Botany Bay flashback.
Oh, that's the original Khan.
Khan.
He looks like a chick.
Yeah, I kind of want to take the calendar down when that month comes around.
Okay, the fight with the Klingons was not shot very well.
What the heck is a Klingon, by the way?
Klingon is an alien species.
They're just aliens.
Klingon. Mm. I found that highly stupid. I'm like, Klingon.
Did they originally symbolized the Nazis. And they were the Nazis in the Federation.
Oh, the political stance in the original?
It was the 60s.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, gosh.
The original Star Trek.
That just keeps getting worse.
Every single episode had a political or historical or philosophical point to make, which is why it's such a great series.
Why do I really tick me off all the time?
I think the Klingon fight was too fast. I couldn't tell what was going on. Who was fighting who?
Yeah, well, that's just a style that they have nowadays.
I hate that. It's just all over the place. I hate that. Give me TOS. I have mixed feelings about Pike's death. Pike has been my favorite character in both films. I love Pike. He's the classic mentor figure.
He was the annoying old man.
He was supposed to be Obi-Wan Kenobi.
He's not
that
annoying.
That was his role.
That is a sick comparison. Knock it off. No,
okay,
really,
well
it is a good
comparison.
Okay, well
then I can pick a different mentor out of a different hero's journey, because
that's what the film is.
Go ahead. A hero's journey.
Feel free.
Yeah.
Who's
okay.
The hero?
Hero Kirk.
Oh.
Kirk and Spock.
I am an anti-hero.
Anti-hero.
You want
anti-hero? Explain. Anti-hero is a rogue. An anti-hero is Boba Fett is an anti-hero.
That's actually not true.
Punisher is an
anti-hero. No, that's actually not true. Look at the definition.
Let me. I have the Webster's Dictionary on my computer. I will look it up.
Feel free. I was gonna ask if this isn't considered real Trek, then what elements are not real Trek in this? I mean, what's?
Oh, things are just presented in more of just kind of a dumb action sort
anti-hero,
of modern
vibe.
Anti-hero,
a central character in a story, movie, or drama who lacks conventional heroic attributes.
Boom. I'm right.
Ooh.
All right. So explain. How is Kirk an anti-hero?
First of all, he doesn't follow orders, which is usually shown in a bad light. I think probably in this situation I would have done the same thing as Kirk.
Say that again.
In Kirk's situation I would have done the same thing. Because I'm not a Spocky person. See, I thought that Spock and Kirk were interesting because Spock was purely intuition and Kirk was sensing, which are two dead opposites when it comes to personality traits. So I found that interesting.
I kind of liked how Pike, he was no longer Kirk's mentor figure.
Mm-hmm.
And that is an element of the hero's journey is you can't always have your mentor with you.
Hi there.
Mr. Brooks.
Yeah.
Who's your favorite character in the film and why?
Oh gosh, I don't have a favorite character. I don't know, I really like Pike. I think he's the most genuinely enjoyable character. I have trouble feeling it with Kirk. We're supposed to enjoy his being mischievous and learning and growing and all that sort of thing, but I don't know, I feel like a lot of his character just doesn't work, especially in the first movie. It was much worse in the first movie. I just thought they went a little overboard with Kirk, you know, showing how he's a ladies' man. A lot of that gets a little silly. They just exaggerated a lot of traits that were in the original show that were just kind of dumb, kind of exaggerated in more of a dumb way. This is a teenager's take on Star Trek versus the maturity that the original universe had. Ironically, because I am a teenager.
Oh yeah, maturity. Continue.
She's only seen one episode of TOS and it was Miri.
Which
is the worst episode of all time. It's the most boring episode.
My father showed it to me.
It's so bad. I don't know.
Take it up with him?
I will have to contact your dad. You should have watched something like Sea on the Edge of Forever or Space Seed. Space Seed would have been fine too.
Which one's your favorite?
My favorite movie is Star Trek the Motion Picture, the one right there, although it's altered version. And my favorite original series episode would be The Menagerie. But when I first saw 2009, I was trying to enjoy it, but there was just so many things that offended me. Kirk flirting with Uhura really offended me. Punching that guy. Just making Kirk such an idiot, kind of. He's just... Well, not in the original universe. Kirk obviously has redeemable aspects, but as far as what Pike saw in him, I don't really know how Pike even saw that, because Kirk chose a path that was just drowning in a bar, and all of a sudden he becomes captain by the end of the movie, and I thought that was a little dumb.
It would have been interesting to see Pike kind of more explain what he saw in Kirk. I wish there was more Pike. I wish he hadn't killed him.
That's the thing. I think the writing in 2009 was extremely underdeveloped.
Ugh.
And the bad guy stuff was just so boring.
Nero was... an idiot.
All of the character relationships in the new movies aren't as believable or interesting because they're not as well developed.
I would agree.
You don't feel like you know them quite as well as you've got to know them on the show.
You did. But this show ran, what, how many episodes did TOS have?
80 episodes if you count The Cage.
80 episodes.
Six movies.
80 episodes, six movies, you got to know the characters.
And all the character development was stretched out during this amount of time. Whereas the new movies are just shoving in new elements, like Spock and Uhura being together.
She can do better than him. A lot better than him. And better than Kirk, too.
If you had to pick one male character that you liked.
Dang, they're all such idiots.
Well, the Cyrano Jones music is playing.
I guess Kirk. I have to pick Kirk.
Why? Because he's the anti-hero.
Because he's there!
That says it all right there, folks. I was very encouraged by the fact that Chris Pine, the guy playing Kirk, and he was being interviewed, and he said the last film was about Captain Kirk becoming captain. and this film is about him earning it. It just didn't work for me. I think there was just more intellectual writing in the original universe, and that's really what makes Star Trek entertaining to me. And this new film had some enjoyable action and such, and I did like things about this movie. As far as my expectations were concerned, it did not surpass them, and it did not... The film wasn't slightly below my expectations. It was
I was expecting another Star Trek 2009, so I was actually impressed by what the film offered.
Benedict Cumberbatch played a good con in this movie. Yeah. The producers were really whipping us around with who Benedict Cumberbatch was playing.
They wouldn't tell him.
The moment I saw him, I don't even know anything about Trek, I thought, I bet that's Khan. The moment I saw him, yeah. I bet you $1 million that's Khan. And they said his name was, John Harrison. I'm like, mm-hmm. Oh, darn it, he's not Khan. And then lo and behold,
this bad guy's name is going to be John Harrison? Yeah, right. In the audio commentary for 2009, the producers joke and say, we thought about having a teaser at the end of the credits. It's the cool thing that all the kids do, you know, with the Marvel movies.
Now, I was waiting for that at the end of the credits. We sat through the credits waiting for that. Other thing I was waiting for was Bender's credit.
Well, I just sit through the credits because it's a respectful thing to do, and I like to take in the whole film.
They have the caterer in the credits.
But it turned out to be Khan all along. What I was going to say is in the 2009 commentary, they said they should have had a teaser with the Botany Bay, but they didn't do that.
What the heck is the Botany Bay?
That's the ship that Khan shows up on, where all of his crew is frozen, and I wanted to see a flashback sequence.
Why the heck is it called the Botany Bay?
Because the Botany Bay was a penal colony in Australia.
Khan liked plants, but that was cut out of the film.
We do disagree about certain things, see?
So you knew Khan would appear?
Well, I knew Khan would appear because Alex Pullen spoiled me.
Alex went to see the film last night and then was all trying to tell Wes and I all about it. We're like, Alex, please, stop!
I'm like, was the movie good, Alex? And he's like, yeah, it was very good, I loved it. And then I said, well, that's great. And he says,
do you
want to
hear a little bit?
Yeah, no, and then I say, well, don't spoil me. And he says, okay, sure. By the way, you might want to watch Star Trek 2 before you see this movie.
Star Trek True is Wrath of Khan.
Star Trek 2,
Khan appears.
So overall, I thought this movie was pretty good. I'll have more insights into it as time goes on.
It takes me at least 2 days to process a film before I can give a good review of it.
It's a weird, ambiguous relationship that I have with these new movies.
Star Trek 2009 was all about pinning the Star Trek name on there and a few accessories people would recognize. Or props, rather.
There was a lot of this in this movie, too. A lot of references from the Star Trek of old.
Oh, there was.
That, or kind of dumb in places. I don't think J.J. Abrams has a real sophistication when it comes to things. I just think he just makes movies.
But the reason why I saw this movie to begin with, because I wanted to get a sense of J.J. Abrams' directing style, because he's doing Star Wars 7. I'm not really afraid for Star Wars 7. I just think it's going to be insignificant, to be honest. I think it's just going to be like...
I think J.J. has a much better shot at doing Star Wars great than Star Trek great.
I would think so. He's not a Trekkie. I thought it was funny though how many lens flares were in the credits.
Lens flares were in the credits.
You should call how many lens flares were in the credits.
Oh, well,
every movement there was a lens flare. They add lens flares to the CGI. That's obsessive.
I really can't stand the alien cultures in this movie.
You don't like the Star Trek vibes.
I don't, that's the thing.
Like the Stargate vibe.
I hate the vibe. It just doesn't work for me. There might be good characters. There might be decent plot lines, but the vibe of the universe just...
This is possibly one of the most audacious things you will ever hear come out of the mouth of this woman.
Spock is the Jar Jar of the Star Trek universe. From an outsider looking in, that's how it seems to me. He's the Jar Jar. Everyone hates him. Everyone's like, whenever he opens his mouth.
No, he's not.
But how come every single person on the Enterprise would go, whenever he'd say anything?
Spock is so logical and everybody knows he's right and they don't want to admit it.
Jar Jar was so annoying. And everyone knows he's not right, and they are happy to admit it, see?
Well, the difference is the audience likes Spock, and everyone hates Jar Jar.
There are people who love Jar Jar.
If the closest thing to Jar Jar in this movie is Scotty's companion.
Who's in Beam Me Up, Scotty?
Kirk.
That line never appeared in the Star Trek franchise. It's a common misquote.
What about, he's dead, Jim? It's worse than I said, Jim.
It's worse than that. His brain is gone.
Who says that?
I'm receiving subspace anomalies. See, I can't do a hurrah.
Okay, do Carol.
Carol?
British accent.
Carol Marcus from Wrath of Khan.
Jim, you were never there for your book.
What was that? Sounds like Carrie Fisher.
I'm kidding. Spock?
Calm your hair down.
Jim, it is highly illogical to assume that these creatures, as we so deem them as yet, can have any logical assumption to the proclivities of nature itself, but if we look at the situation logically, we can presume that the factual idolomercies are not only not in the dictionary.
Kirk.
Kirk himself.
Oh boy, here we
do one Shatner.
Okay, alright,
here we go.
This is what I do best.
Miss Spock, we need warp drive now. Oh wait, you're my first officer. Scotty is the guy I talked to for warp drive. Scotty, we need warp drive now. You see those Klingons? They will blast us into smithereens. Blast us into oblivion. 1,000,000,000 terrible things coming this way. Mr. Scott, I need warp engines now. Guy, the ship's gonna blow, Captain.
I cannot give her any more power, Captain. She's
I
gonna.
I can't give her any
I'm
more
giving
power,
her all
Captain.
She's got.
Jim, he's worse than dead. His brain is gone.
No, not that episode.
Do the old dude that died. Your favorite dude that you say is like your favorite.
Oh, Pike?
Favorite?
He Pike? Dies. He's
Pike.
The old man
yeah,
that
Pike.
Died at the beginning.
Pike.
Pike doesn't appear in TOS
he's,
so much.
He's a different character. I will do him from the menagerie.
You'd have to see the episode, Sophie.
Alright, so now we're watching the original Star Trek The Motion Picture. And he's finally done.
Not over yet. Okay, now it's
over. All right, so. Here she is. Right there on the left. There, in that chair right there. Boom.
Today will be a day long remembered. Folks, what I'm about to share with you is unbelievable. Because Sophie Newton, longtime established anti-Trek queen, is inviting me to see the Star Trek Into Darkness, the new Star Trek movie, as you well know by now, today, again, for a second time. And her siblings are gonna pick me up in about 5 minutes, and gee whiz, we're gonna go see the movie. And me and Sophie were texting back and forth, and the things she was saying were incredibly foreign to me. Just these things coming out of her mouth. Absolutely unbelievable. The big thing she's getting into is the relationship between Kirk and Spock, or the relationship between Spock and Uhura. She's being very interested in that. That's like her gateway to start accepting the Star Trek universe, albeit the new movie, which isn't really close to what Star Trek is, but nevertheless, it's an imitation of it. And Sophie, she almost called herself a Trekkie earlier today. So we'll see how this new showing goes.
Sophie, what is happening?
I don't know.
What is happening?
I just woke up one morning and I'm like, I'm a Trekkie now. I love Spock and I love Uhura and I love them together.
So you just called yourself a Trekkie?
I did.
Me too.
See, I'm wearing my hair
this
like
Uhura. Oh my gosh, this is the first official time that you've called yourself, announced yourself
Trekkie,
as a Trekkie.
But this is extremely under wraps. No one can know about it.
Absolutely. The thing that I find crazy is that you were the one who wanted to see it again.
I know. I have to see it again, or I feel like I'm going to die if I don't see it again.
That's nuts.
I have to.
Unbelievable.
I know.
Oh, it's a big frog!
Where is he?
Where's the right there on your
oh,
arm.
He's huge.
Jason!
No, I can't.
Wow!
Oh, it came under again. Okay. I got it. I hold
you got it, Grace.
Oh, what's cute. I love frogs.
What are you going to name him?
Spock!
Spock! Oh my goodness.
It's so cute. Oh my god.
Close up.
It's really cute.
Okay. In the window.
Did it taste like boss nass?
Yes.
So Grace, you're tagging along.
Yes.
But you have absolutely no interest in seeing this.
Yeah, I don't like Star Trek very much.
I was gonna say, how is EJ gonna come to this? But now I see that she's not here, so.
I came with an open mind last time, but
as did I
didn't like it very much. I think I came with a closed mind. I was like, I'm gonna hate this, but I didn't. It was weird. Maybe that's the key. You have to come with a closed mind.
So Sophie, this will take a lot for you to admit this, but were you kind of pretending to dislike it?
Yes.
Wow.
When I got out, I was kind of like, oh, that was stupid. Really, I was like, ooh, her is cool.
Yeah, I had the suspicion that
you
this might.
How did you?
wrecked your mind.
I don't like Uhura.
I don't know. She just seemed like a character that you'd like.
Yeah, she did.
I didn't wear my hair like Uhura for nothing.
Well, I'm curious to see if I'll have any new thoughts seeing it again.
You'll probably like it better this time.
I think so. I think I'll love it more for what it is.
I didn't love Retaliation as much the first time, but then when I saw it again, I really liked it.
Okay.
And then the third and fourth time, well, you know.
You saw it four times?
Yeah. Wow. And I saw Les Mis four times, too.
Okay. So Sophie?
Yes.
What did you like about the first movie, now that you're being honest?
The first movie. Oh.
Or this
well,
one.
The
first
I loved
time seeing
the relationship
it.
Between Spock and Uhura. Yeah. I was like awing when they kissed. I was like, oh. There it is. Right there. All the way up.
Boy, it just smells like a theater in here. You're buying snacks? Now the crunch will take away from the soundtrack.
No, I'll crunch quietly.
I can't believe we're seeing this again.
I am.
That's just terrific.
I love
Oh, we're not seeing 3D, are we?
No.
Thank God. Thank you. You know what worked out, Sophie? In the last theater, they didn't have any Star Trek posters.
I know.
But now that you're into it, kind of,
I'm happy.
There are Star Trek posters around here. The popcorn glass isn't as entertaining, though, as the one at the Landmark. Unbelievable! Unbelievable!
Hold on, Sophie, hold on. Okay, where is she? There she is. Zoe Saldana, right next to Zachary Quinto.
And what did you say about Zoe the last time?
I said that she ruins action movies, but I was very, very,
No, she
very
ruins
wrong.
Sci-fi movies.
I was very wrong. Very wrong. Well, if I die, I'll die happy because I'll be watching My Bigger Trouble.
Sophie, is this thing going to last?
What thing?
Your Uhura Spock Star Trek interest.
No, it's not. It'll fizzle out.
But she won't completely deny it. She might not be into it for a time. But how can you completely erase what you've the progress you've made here?
I already love it. Gwyneth Paltrow's in Iron Man 3.
You don't like Gwyneth Paltrow?
Oh, I hate her. She's awful.
What if she was in a Star Trek movie all of a sudden?
I still hate her.
What if she was in a Star Wars movie all of a sudden and you
I
really liked
her? I'd hate her more.
Would you hate Zoe, whatever her face is, if she was in a Star Trek movie?
No, a Star Wars? I want Zoe to be in Star Wars. I wanted to be
Well, would you hate her if she was in a Star Trek movie?
Zoe Saldana is in a Star Trek movie.
Well, according to 2 weeks ago, you wouldn't have proved.
I know, but now I love her. Did you know she was a ballerina? Just like me.
Okay, we made it out of the vicinity, or out of the building.
I kept awing during the Spock and Uhura scenes, but I tried to keep it down, so not disturbing.
Ah, and it stopped raining. My opinion of it has changed. I think it was a good film for what it was.
Since I'm a non-Trekkie and I'm saying it's good, that means it's good. Well, I just called myself a Trekkie like a couple hours earlier, so yeah, I'm a Trekkie.
I don't know if you can call yourself a Trekkie for liking the new movie, but I'll fly with it.
Yeah, sure. I'm a new Trekkie. But Wes, I think that Spock and Uhura is the hardest thing to fanfic about, for me at least, because A, I don't know very much about the Trek universe, and B, that's just hard. Like, technically their relationship shouldn't work.
Exactly, because it was just squeezed in there in the last movie to have something for Uhura to do.
Well, they said they really wanted to bring out his half-human side, which I think is interesting, but then they need to flesh that out a little bit.
Exactly.
They don't really play it up. They're just like, okay, sometimes he gives in to his human side, but sometimes he's this Vulcan dude. It doesn't work.
Yeah, the thing with the writers is they have these great themes and ideas for stuff to do with characters, but I don't know if they properly nourish them enough.
I don't think they do. I think Spock and Uhura could work in a way that would make some sense, but they need to flesh it out more.
Doesn't make much sense when you compare it to the old show.
I don't like to.
I guess that's not really the point, though, because it's about how the movie works on its own.
Yeah.
Separated from all the previous stuff.
You can't be stuck in the past.
On those merits, I think there's still some things that don't work with it. I think a lot of people are probably confused about Khan and some of the plot elements of that.
Yeah, I think Khan was handled very sloppily. They kind of threw him in there, made him do some stuff.
He seemed to be more of a plot device than anything else.
Yeah.
Because they needed his blood to fix, what was his name?
Kirk.
And they also needed a bad guy.
Yeah. They needed a bad guy. Yeah.
And that's sort of, they kind of used him as a sympathetic character, too. Like, you expect Khan to be the main bad guy, but here's Admiral Grumpy Pants.
And they need somebody to help him get into the Admiral's ship. And so he was just a plot device again.
Yeah, I feel like a lot of things were just plot devices.
I think also what happened is they may have had a lot of that stuff, but it kind of got lost in the editing room.
I doubt that. I sincerely doubt that.
Well, but they wanted, I think they probably, it
that's what happened
longer.
With Kingdom of the Crystal Skull.
It should have been longer. I don't think 2 hours was enough to...
Well, this is a pretty long movie.
Yeah, it was too long.
I think the action took away from some of the stuff that we would want.
I think they didn't need the action sequences to be.
Well, this is an action movie, first and foremost.
How long did Spock fight Khan for?
Well, what these new movies are is taking the gimmicks of the old show and exploiting them in a way that's never been done before with big budget and special effects they didn't have 45 years ago with the old show. They were there to tell stories, and a lot of iconic things came from that. And so they're just trying to rehash... A lot, you know, like everybody in the theater laughing at the lines that you didn't understand why were funny.
I was just like, why is that funny?
Yeah, it's catchphrases, references to the old show. So it's just bringing all that stuff back for nostalgic reasons and marketing it as an action film to people who know nothing about Star Trek and just giving old people something to, you know, remember. And but for hardcore Star Trek fans, these movies are more of an enigma.
Now, are these connected to the... original stuff in any way, like prequel or
Khan was the most famous bad guy from
the
original.
But does
you knew that though.
Link up to any of the other continuities? Like, are they connected,
or is it just a complete reboot?
Well, actually, 2009 would help that question be answered.
Yeah.
The filmmakers talking about how this was a standalone movie. I can't imagine how confused somebody would be seeing the movie and Spock saying, "Hello, Spock." Hello, Spock. You know, when the two old Spock and young Spock are talking to each other, if you didn't see the previous movie, you'd be like, what? What's going on?
I
think
old Spock,
old Spock was definitely, Leonard Nimoy was sort of shoved in there.
That's a big, you know, celebrity guest.
Yeah, it didn't work, though.
No, it didn't.
I think they should have left that alone. It was exposition and here's old Spock.
Yeah.
Rather than him really having something to contribute.
Yeah. He just kind of, like, what was the thing about him promising never to give him information that would alter his destiny? Well, I didn't even get that. Is that from the 2009?
Okay, well, yeah. That's where all that stuff came from.
Okay, because I was so lost.
And also, some of the character stuff that goes on, I'll see, one instance in particular, when old Spock said, you don't know what the cost was or something like that. Like, defeating Khan came at a great cost.
Yeah.
Well, if you didn't see Star Trek II, The Wrath of Khan, so many things in this movie were taken from the original stuff to evoke emotional recognition.
Yeah.
Which wouldn't be there for newgoers.
Yeah.
Spock her up forever.
So Sophie, we're thinking that we're gonna have everybody over tomorrow, or
to
James
watch.
John at least to
Star
watch.
Star Trek 2009.
Yes.
But the thing is, the only person outside of my own family who knows that I like Star Trek is Wes. And it has to stay in my followers on fanfic.net, but that's not my name.
Star Trek.
Not original.
So have you posted anything on fanfic?
I changed my profile saying that I like it. So this is what we're going to say. We're going to say that I was really confused by Into Darkness, and we're not going to tell them that we saw it twice. We're just going to pretend like I only saw it once. So I'm confused. And
what
I'm
do we do
like,
when we reveal this, though?
It's going to be in trouble.
Okay, so I'm going to be like, I didn't understand it, so I'm going to watch 2009. Or, this is better, you could say, come on, Sophie, you have to watch it, and I'll be like, fine. and you'll be like, come on, you'll like it. And I'll be like, sure. And then we'll watch it and I'll be like, well, that was lame. And then we'll kick James and John out. And then I'll be squealing over the Spocker moments.
This could be very entertaining. To set this up, though, we'd have to make sure you arrive sooner and stay later than James and John.
Yes.
That's the dilemma.
So I can be like, so you're going to give him a phony time?
This plan, in its very definition, is immortal.
Sophie, I want to thank you, because if not for you, I would have never seen this film twice in the theater.
You probably would have liked it either.
And there was a lot to add to it because of the theater we saw it at, with the sound quality and all that. But anyway.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So here I am on a previously rainy day, and folks, it is absolutely unreal. Well, first of all, it's gorgeous out here, which is only appropriate, because Sophie has... sort of entered the world of Star Trek in a positive way. And coming back from seeing Star Trek Into Darkness really reaffirmed that for her. These new Star Trek movies have been such an enigma for all us Star Trek fans. But the fact that this new movie had some fun elements, had weaknesses, absolutely it did, but it had some great things in it that were very enjoyable, and it did its job to make someone who wanted nothing to do with Trek genuinely enjoy it and be interested in it.
I think at some point, and I think it's already happening, Sophie called herself a Trekkie, and she's sort of saying that her interest in it is through Spock and Uhura. But as she continues to delve into this world, undoubtedly it's going to become more than just an interest in Spock and Uhura as characters in these new movies. Because how can you love the characters and not love the universe? However, Sophie dislikes the original series very much and the original universe. But I have a feeling that she'll warm up to them eventually, even though she still has the same feelings about those that she had about Star Trek in general prior to seeing a movie which she genuinely enjoyed. She's just taken her first step into a larger world. Here I am outside of our beautiful local library, and I am here to pick up the Star Trek 2009 disc.
Ladies and gentlemen, something disastrous has occurred. Star Trek 2009 is nowhere to be seen at the library. I spent 20 minutes there searching back and forth, raiding the shelves trying to find it. No trace of it. Such a search for something so trivial as the last new movie. But Sophie is coming to the rescue.
Any moment now, James or Sophie and her siblings, and James's brother John, will be here. We will explore the film of much controversy amongst us Trekkies. It came out 4 years ago. There they are. Right there. And if Sophie likes this film, the circle will be complete for her first entry into the Star Trek world. Of course, James and I do not like the movie. We'll see how she feels about it. I'm giving the Vulcan salute right now. Oh my gosh, what is happening?
I'm here.
You're actually making the sign?
The Vulcan salute.
What in the world is happening?
Live long and prosper.
Oh my gosh.
No, I'm not.
You should call this Sophie's Journey to Trekdom.
This is exactly what this is. And there it is, the Blu-ray. I am so proud of you for getting that.
It's beautiful.
Unbelievable. This is probably one of the best movies you could watch in HD.
I'm so excited.
The HD quality is really good.
Let me freak out before the rest come.
Yeah.
Are you ready?
So EJ absolutely hates Star Trek 2.
Uh-huh, and I never will like it.
And my goodness, that's what Sophie once said, but what is happening?
I love it so much.
Well,
you have Zoe Saldana to thank for that, okay?
Oh,
you should
gosh.
Write her a letter and be like, thank you, you converted my friend to Trek.
I mean, she's the very thing that you thought was terrible about it.
I know. I'm so embarrassed that I dissed on her. I am so sorry,
I love how
Zoe.
You have the Batman thing documented, and now you have all the Star Trek documented.
Yeah. Wait, what about Batman?
Well, you once hated Batman, and I have the footage of you saying that you hated him.
You didn't have the footage of you saying
I hate Zoe Saldana.
I love Zoe.
Yeah, I don't have that one.
But I'll never be a Hunger Games fan.
Well, that's a good thing.
Yeah.
How is the world treating you with your new fandom?
Not well.
Not well?
I've been my own.
Well, your household, for one thing.
Yeah.
Tell me about this.
Well,
this is so psychological.
Eli's going back to physically beating me up now. And he would not speak to me yesterday. Every time I walked past him, he just mumbled, I can't believe you like Trek, 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 Trek. And he actually beat me up. So things aren't going well in my side of the neighborhood.
Me and Eli actually yesterday cornered Sophie and said they're going, no more Trek.
That's their, awesome. This is
no,
their
Sophie.
Anti-Trek symbol. I don't even know what that
symbol. This is the anti-Trek symbol.
But I've gone
sure I'm a Trek.
Back to... Okay, so hilarious. You want to tell you all the Trekkiness that's been going on? Okay, so the other day someone accused me of lying. One of my siblings and I said, Vulcans do not lie. And they were like, you can't say that. I'm like, I just did. I think we need to come up with a sign that means, like, I really like this or something.
Yes.
Like, two coughs or something. Be like, But that's kind of obvious.
So obvious.
Oh, what if I go, oh, boo, every time that happens? Well, no, but see, I can never...
The acting, though, would ruin that.
I can never do that when Spock and Uhura are kissing. I'll be like,
Sophie, you just are going to scream, oh.
I am. I'm
She's
not even going to.
She's been watching videos on YouTube of it. Like,
I have.
All morning.
That's unbelievable. This is just a shocking thing. Sorry, I was doing a special effect. Here's the problem. How are we going to explain the fact that you spent money to rent this?
Oh. How are we going to... I'll just say I got it. Big deal. I'll be like all cool and cocky, but I'll be like, I got it. Big deal.
Yeah. Sounds good. Sounds good.
What's it to you?
Oh, Grace and I were driving the other day, and she was driving our big junker of a van.
I'm doing a J.J. Abrams shot. I'm doing a J.J. Abrams shot right now.
And she's like... Oh my gosh. She's like, I feel like I'm driving the Starship Enterprise, and you're Spock, and I'm Kirk. And I'm like, this is so cool.
Let me know when you're getting sick of my J.J. Abrams shot. Okay.
Grace is now a fan of, is it Chekhov? Is that his name?
Chekhov is the sort of the younger guy that took over engineering.
Grace loves him.
Really?
Yeah, because he's named after some, Anton Chekhov, isn't he named after some Russian, I don't even know what he was, like a poet or something. Mm-hmm. And Grace is like, he was hot. She's like, he was so hot. And she's like, I gotta find myself a hot Russian man like him. And I'm just like, this is weird.
I can't imagine Grace calling anybody hot.
Spock and Uhura. I love Spock and Uhura. I love Spock and Uhura.
Don't do it. Don't do it. They're right there. Don't do it. You can't do it. They're right there. There's James and John. All right. Put on.
This is such crap. I can't even hold this. You hold this. It's crap.
Okay. All right. Fine.
I feel so wrong.
All right, you're gonna have to hold your composure there. Oh, look what you guys did!
Yes.
Oh, you guys are epic. Oh my gosh.
I'm probably the only person on the planet that would wear a Star Trek shirt over a collared button-up shirt.
I didn't even know that happened. I didn't even know that was possible.
I
think the world will fall in on itself now that this has been attempted.
I've done worse things, I'm
Enterprise
sure.
in hand.
Of course.
Oh man, you wouldn't believe the story to get this.
We
got the Star Trek Blu-ray here.
Mm-hmm.
I went to the library, being a very naive optimist, thinking, well, I know the new movies come out, but of course the new Star Trek will be there. It wasn't. I freaked out. So he's not excited to see this movie, as you can tell. But she does want to see it though. She's curious about it. But anyway, I pleaded with Sophie to go to the movie store and pick it up. So she spent her money on this.
Yeah, really. $4 of my money down the drain. On Trek.
All right. So let's go ahead in and watch this. James, do your Enterprise thing. Do it again. James Ware, an exclusive interview with you before we watch the 2009 ordeal again. Sophie's cynical non-Trek face is well in the camera lens right now. James, what was the psychological effect of the 2009 film that you're about to revisit?
Well, a lot of people thought that it was the rebirth of Star Trek. I fell into the hype originally in 2009, but my parents deemed me too young to go see it in the movie theater.
Yeah.
Which is probably best. I saw it about a year later in 2010, and I already knew it was a horror film when I was watching it, and it didn't disappoint me. I thought it was good at first, but it has so many plot holes and so many errors, it's not a Star Trek film.
You, of course, wouldn't have liked what they did with the characters as well.
Ooh.
In places.
No. Spock was way too emotional. They blew up Vulcan. You can't blow up Vulcan. That.
No, they imploded it, didn't they?
Something with the red matter. It was the Death Star to Alderaan was what that was. You know, and they had Kirk on his motorcycle doing his twin sons moment.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
For a Trek.
Oh, I'm really gonna enjoy this.
For an anti-Trek person to watch Star Trek 2009, they'd go, "Wow, this is just so many things are taken from Star Wars here." And you watch the documentary, the behind the scenes, and the writers are like, they have a whole section in the behind the scenes for this movie where they go,
"What can we learn from Star Wars?"
Yeah, what can we learn from Star Wars? Did that offend you like it offended me? It's like, come on, you can say that you're making an action film without saying we want to be faster like Star Wars is. And for crying out loud, Star Wars is so much more classical music than your movie is.
Amen, bro.
You know, because that's what they were saying. They were saying, Star Wars is like rock music and jazz. And
that is offensive.
And Star Trek is like beautiful classic.
Who said that? Was it Abrams?
See why we hate J.J. Abrams?
It was the writers of the film.
Was the Abrams the writer?
No. Because he knows nothing about Trek. He couldn't write the movie.
Whoa.
He just directed it.
Okay,
he just told where the camera goes and all that. Well, he also had a vision for how the writing would be interpreted, of course, but he was not...
It didn't work.
Yeah.
It'll be interesting to see what a couple of people that have never seen Star Trek 2009 think of it.
Especially after seeing it backwards since you saw the new movie last.
Die Hard Warsies.
All right, John.
Trek Warsies.
John, what did you think of 2009?
I can barely remember it.
Really? Well, I saw it in the theater on my birthday, and I was disgusted by so much in the movie. There was, especially the bar stuff early on with Uhura and Kirk. I was just.
And Spock and Kirk.
Yes, I could not.
And Pike and Kirk. And the two red shirts and Kirk and the...
Star Trek 2009 was a disappointment. But anyway, we're going to document our viewing experience of it again as we launch into what came out 4 years ago, ready to go. There it is. All right, let's pop it in.
Hey, look, Wes, it's infinitely better than Star Trek 2009. NASCAR.
Not true. I wish I could say that was true because I just like the movie.
Look at that.
That, I love that. The Enterprise redesign, I like motion picture better, but it's not too bad. Better than what they did with everything else.
Wait, that is the Enterprise? Mm-hmm. That's the thing you're flying around.
Yeah.
You knew that, Sophie. Come on.
No, I didn't. I swear I didn't.
You didn't know this was the Enterprise?
We're not planning on watching the preview.
Wait, is there only one Enterprise?
No.
Then there was the Enterprise.
How long have you been rambling about the different
time.
Enterprises?
Then there was the Enterprise.
Because I
want to
take
done.
All of it
I'm
and speed
done.
It up.
Then there
sound like a chipmunk.
Then there was the Enterprise D, which Captain Picard flew on to Star Trek The Next Generation. Then there was the Enterprise E, which Captain Picard flew on in some of the movies. Then
hey, I got a better question. What does USS stand for?
United Spaceship. They don't say it much because it sounds so stupid.
A ship! A ship! Get it? A ship!
Shall we begin?
Now, shall we begin? Parents strongly caution some material may be inappropriate for children under 13 for sci-fi violence, action, violence, and other stuff.
PG-13. Trekkies maybe needed to be shut up while in the theater.
Why is we allowed to boo during this?
Yeah.
Boo! No!
I do like the music.
I would ask that you not boo to her.
I won't boo to her, I'll boo to everybody else though because I don't like anybody else.
You see, I have a soft spot for these movies. I think they could have been very good if the writing was just a little bit more solid and there was less gratuity in it.
There was potential.
There's a lot of potential.
What's with the bad robot?
No, it's coming up here.
I never got that.
Oh, Bad Robot is JJ's company.
No, what? Is it going to be in front of Star Wars?
Why is
I guess
robot?
It will be.
Yeah, it will be.
You can't
okay, here's the opening shot. This is just a sweet opening shot.
Quiet. Oh, and this is the free talking room?
This whole time, free streaming to try to find the inside.
I do. Alright, we're trying to find R2-D2. Can we pass him?
No.
I saw him.
Did you?
Yeah, I think I really did.
Would that be him?
That might be him. No, it was a clearer shot than that.
Huh.
No, it's right there. Can I see him?
Where?
Right over the dude's head. See, it looks like a...
Right there?
Nope.
It is right over
that,
there.
Yes, that's it.
No, it's not it.
Yes, it is.
Is it not R2?
It looks like a TC is moving.
He's got... It's a really good version of R2. It's clearer than that. See, that's just a piece of three.
Huh.
No, must be another shot.
Or did we just miss
or
it?
Or perhaps I'm right.
The R2-D2 cameo in the debris field, which really does exist. I'm not making this up. See, there's Spock. He sees R2. Alright, watch. Go. Right there.
What?
Keep going. No, maybe it's different. But I did see him fly through.
Is that him?
Yeah, I would go.
Is that
I
him
would,
on the
video? Yes, I would say that for
you. There. Right there.
Really?
Yeah.
You're right, that is him.
I
see it, you're right.
Right there.
Okay, do you gotta get zoom in on it, John?
Yes.
Yep.
Zoom in on R2. I can't believe I almost did that.
That's so wrong. I never
realized.
Oh, man. Oh, that's wrong.
I suddenly need to put an R2 screen
on.
I can't believe that's in there.
Okay, what's going on, Sophie?
I am now a Trekkie.
What?
I saw Into Darkness, and I loved it. So I went home, and I got the Alan T. Foster Star Trek 2009 novelization out of the library. I read it. Then yesterday, I forced Wes to go see Star Trek Into Darkness again.
You did?
I did.
You didn't tell me this.
I did not.
It was supposed to be under rest. Where, and yes, I will confess it, I love Spock, I love Uhura, and I love them as a couple. They're adorable.
Oh.
But I still don't, and I have gone so insanely Trekkie.
Did you watch any TOS?
No. Okay, before you pulled up, she was doing that to Wes. I was, I did
yep.
it to Wes, and I said, live long and prosper.
And wow. I didn't tell you that I saw it yesterday because Sophie wanted to keep it from
Welcome
everybody.
To the family, Sophie.
And Eli told Sophie that she was lying, and
it's good to be part of a family, Captain.
Oh,
my brother horrible. Is trying to deny it that I like Star Trek, and I've actually been estranged from my family, and I've been physically beat up multiple times. So
it's okay, Sophie. The Trekkies accept many people.
So, wow, they're not even freaking out. I thought they'd freak out a little bit more.
They're all in a state of shock.
Yes. Vulcan minds the blood.
Now, I want everybody to clap for Sophie's bold new decision.
Why is she not clapping?
That's because I have to hold the camera.
Sophie, stop now.
Sophie, we salute you for your honesty.
Thank you.
And
no,
you've been,
we don't.
And you've been, she just did the sound.
I would rather have her lie.
And okay, Sophie, you've been booing this whole time as insincerely.
Oh, I searched online for an Uhura cosplay dress, but I couldn't find one that was anywhere near my price point.
So, Sophie.
No, yes, Salvation Army.
Would you wear a Star Trek uniform?
Yes.
Yeah. Wow.
You gotta check.
That is progress.
When you're looking at shirts, check for the black rim. This is very unique when it comes to shirts.
Gotcha. I have just been pretending to hate this, and Wes and I have been laughing, and you know what?
Yeah, and Sophie got here on purpose early so she could say, all right, now don't tell James and don't tell John, because I'll be so humiliated.
But then I decided to just let it free, and now I'm going to enjoy this thing, and I'm going to be squealing through this entire scene.
You gotta watch Star Trek motion picture now and enjoy
No. It has to have Spock and her romance, or else they won't.
Wait, did any two let? I don't think Uhura may have had a crush on Spock.
Yes, she did.
No, I don't think so.
Online.
It was more Nurse Chapel than the major crush.
There was just one scene. What you're referring to was a scene where Uhura was just sort of teasing him a little bit.
That's one way to interpret it.
Which episode's that?
I think it would have been the Man Trap, actually. When Spock had command.
She was singing about him in Charlie X.
Yeah, there was that, too.
She sings?
Mm-hmm. Well, he plays the harp.
I have to see that!
The Vulcan harp. The Vulcan Lirette. The Vulcan Lirette, yes.
I have to see that episode.
Sophie, I have an opinion about Spock. I think he's the Jar Jar Banks of the Star Trek universe.
I still could agree with that. I'm glad Uhura likes him. I don't think I would ever date him, but good for her.
You need to send out an email to her.
He is kind of cute, though. I'm a Trekkie. How did that happen? Oh, and for the past...
How many days has it been?
Since Monday. And every day since Monday, except for today, I've worn my hair like Uhura and my makeup like Uhura. Every day.
Wow. Wow.
Oh, and I read the comic books at Barnes & Noble, and I've started multiple fanfics about them.
Wow.
Multiple?
Jay's about to, like, explode.
Way to go, Sophie. Oh my gosh, what in the world? I'm gonna have so much nostalgia for Sophie's anti-Trek life.
I know. Let's feel reborn.
Let's reminisce and play some clips from the Nerd Wars podcast.
Pretty much I consider myself an all-around nerd.
He's a dirty Trekkie!
There's no such thing as a dirty Trekkie.
He's a Trekkie. Low-down beep Trekkie.
Trekkies just gallivant all over the world, going to the future birthplace of Captain Kirk.
That is not
a bad
thing.
And they stand next to the sign and do the Vulcan hand sign and go, duh.
I hate Star Trek.
I will never touch Star Trek again.
Star Trek fans are extremely cocky and extremely pompous.
I have no respect for Trekkies.
Trek! Now this is, you're gonna get into Star Trek, this is what you need to read.
Well, lucky for me, I'm not gonna get into Star Trek.
Well, that's a shame.
Your brain was mushing as it goes, Trek. I hope you don't follow in your big brother's footsteps and become an evil Trekkie.
This morning, she was on the computer looking up stuff, and she's like, Star Trek is so dumb.
Even though I hate him and his Trekkie ideals,
I will never touch Star Trek again. I will never touch Star Trek again.
I hate Star Trek.
I will never touch Star Trek again.
Sophie,
Flip, Long, and Prosper.
This documentation process has turned out to be an epic
journey for me.
Arc, a character
it
arc
has.
Of Sophie Newton.
It really has. We're gonna watch this and psychoanalyze it.
It's gonna be played at your wedding.
It's been
fun.
Sure.
Just loop it.
Sure.
Once you marry one of George Lucas's heirs.
Yes.
Or the CEO of Disney, anyway.
Ooh. Does Gene Roddenberry have any relatives?
Oh my goodness. What about Rod Roddenberry? You want to marry him? He's a little old for you, though,
he's
and he's already married.
Well,
he's in his 30s.
I can't give up on Chet yet. Oh, marry Zachary Quinto. Simple.
Okay, very good.
There you go.
He's a little old for you too, though.
No.
So Sophie's a Trekker now, and James is going to appropriately end this in the classic fanboy way.
Come!